about to leave and saw some pinhole leaks form in my radiator. So I'm using this JB weld, tank weld. It was supposed to be for emergency uses, but now I'm using it in the driveway. And I don't know if it's gonna work too well. But I've used it in emergencies in the past and it seemed to hold up, so we'll see. The spit so I can form it without it sticking to my glove. The 880 California to North Carolina trip was full of this. I bought these extra belts because the ones on the car look really suspect. Actually, I probably should replace those. I am taking off the power steering pump belt so I can take off these AC compressor alternator belts. Of course. Normally you don't have to take the entire power steering pump loose to get the belt off, but I think they got the wrong size belt on here. Then you gotta snake the belt out of the fan, which is a game in itself.
Made in USA, so you know that's old.
Now I gotta take the alternator loose so I can get the belts off of this air conditioned compressor. I like to replace all the belts with brand new belts because if one's that old and fails, the other ones aren't too far behind it. Plus, sometimes you gotta take off multiple belts to get to the belt that you need, which don't make the rookie mistake of putting the wrong belt on first and then having to take it back off again. Thing is, I had to have them order in some belts because you want to try to get a match set of belts on these Chryslers, because if they weren't made around the same time or at least the same construction, one's going to wear out sooner than the other one or not get as tight as it needs to be and then be flopping, which is probably why the old belt was like the way it was, where it was worn thin and flopping. But in an emergency situation, it doesn't really matter too much. So on power steering pumps, most of them have a square cutout that a half inch drive ratchet will go right into, which you can use to put leverage on it to tighten the belt up. Your used belts and keep them in the trunk for the emergency belts if these ever decide to snap for whatever reason. and you'll still have the boxes to know what part numbers you used. The spare tire has 10.7 pounds in it, so that's not very good. Looking at things under the hood to see if there was anything suspect, and I noticed that the radiator had some wet spots on it, and at first I thought it might have been from when I rinsed off the car, but it felt a little sticky and it smelled a little sweet, so obviously it was cooling. So wiped it away, and there's little pinholes in the tank of the radiator. It is the original radiator, so it's probably just got, you know, corroded and the pinholes are leaking. So I put that tank epoxy on there, which I've used in the past in emergencies. And it might be okay, or more leaks might form, or the tank might separate from the core, I don't know, hard to say. Virginia. Is that really established in 1872? Dang, that place is cool. A little bit of a hiss, so I got a little bit of a leak somewhere. We'll just not worry about it. Still got plenty of oil, but I think we're good to go. That's pretty cool. Hopefully they have space for weary travelers.
Looks kind of busy. That was annoying. Park away from the establishment so they don't think that I'm abandoning my car here. This doesn't take very long. Tightening up this power steering pump again. Belt's a little loose, so it's kind of squalling going down the highway. Half expecting someone to come over here and yell at me. It ain't squeaking anymore, but I guess that's what I get for putting a new belt on. The old belt didn't make any noise. Oh well. We're driving away from Edelweiss Restaurant. That's what's happening. We're about to get on that highway, point this thing north, and just start driving till the road ends. Okay, take a ride here.
country lunch buffet. Well, we've made it to Harrisonburg, Virginia, and we're staying at the Village Inn. Car didn't really have any trouble other than having to tighten up the belts. Otherwise, smooth sailing. Buckle up. Hope there's breakfast at some point because I'm starving. And how do I get out of here? I didn't leave any drops of anything on the road. Parking spot, surprisingly. So good, I guess. Looks like my radiator leaks have healed themselves somewhat.
Where are we?
Carlisle, PA. feel like this is how every town in Pennsylvania is.
Yeah.
Seatbelt. We just got some pizza from Alfredo's Pizza Cafe. Whoa. Check this out. I dump it all over the interior. Not that other trash pizza by Alfredo's. We don't want none of that.
Big boy?
Oh, they drove that thing here. I think I watched a video about that.
Like, they drove it under its own
power? I thought so.
Never seen broccoli on a pizza before. Deep dish.
How do they have a subway out here? I don't understand. Where's the traffic? We're in New York. Where's it all at?
I thought I just saw a taxi.
Where? faster cars only nothing in tow. How would that even fit in there?
Okay, let's go measure.
Let's go measure, I guess. That looks awfully narrow. Holy crap. Man, everything here's rusty. Look at that, rust. Things aren't even that old. They're all rusty. Well, it says passenger cars only, but I feel like my car's too wide.
Let me get out.
Look at this.
Oh my God.
Look. That's a tight fit, boys.
Are we gonna have to come back across?
Yeah. These railings on here, but man, that's tight. Bad time for the car to stall.
Let's
see, this bridge was built in 1854, the Downsville covered bridge. Oh man, this is gonna blow a tire out on this freaking lot. I don't know why they put that railing on there, but
I guess they don't want like trucks.
Hey, let me get out.
What are you getting out for? What are you gonna run across the bridge?
Yeah, trust me.
If you really want to run across the bridge, I guess. Bottom of the falls.
Carrying chairs, carrying coolers.
Man, I don't know. Oh no. Shouldn't have parked there. But in his defense, the no parking sign was missing. Imagine having to hike up that thing, go to the mountains.
Oh, there is.
Oh, here comes the police. Oh, crap. Really?
It's a nice waterfall, but I don't think I'd hike up this.
I guess maybe. Yeah, it's straight away.
Oh, yeah, they're right behind.
I could follow behind him and go fast myself. Man, I could smell his brakes. He's probably just having a good time. This guy's like, what was that? Why are people down here? It's like, they didn't even make it to the falls. They're just like...
Big lands.
Ain't even the same cop. This is something else. Gotta make sure you got your boom boom. Imagine having to carry that thing all the way up. Oh, that's crazy, those cliffs. Things I hate, traffic jams. And ooh, that almost was a wreck right there. Everybody's paying attention. People are like, look at those tourists from North Carolina with their phone recording a traffic jam. They must not have traffic jams in North Carolina. Traffic.
ice water.
Knockoff
statue of Liberty.
That's right. So I'm all good.
I know. But what did you get to do?
Got to eat that pastrami.
Yeah.
That pastrami sandwich. It's all I wanted to do in New York City, to have pastrami sandwich. about a quart low, so went across the street to the Sunoco and got a quarter of the cheapest stuff and borrowed their funnel. Bolt there, looks like there's some oil seeping around it. I'll bring their funnel back. A little loose. Over a quarter of a tank, so I probably don't need to try to trick people in finding my gas cap, because in New Jersey you can't pump your own gas. You have to have somebody that's specially trained and goes to a school for pumping gas to pump your gas. Same with Oregon. Oregon's the only other state that you can't pump your own gas. But they do have a lot of full service stations because of having to pump your own gas, so they have like all the oil, the belts, and actually have garages. So I guess in a way it is kind of better in some ways, but annoying because if you go to a gas station, there's only one guy, you gotta wait for him to come pump your gas and stuff. So oh well.
About it, they don't know.
No turn signal. I didn't even know if he was trying to get over. I should have pushed him into the guardrail.
Thank you.
fuel lights on. Gas? What in the...
Well, some people are getting gas.
What in the heck is going on here?
You have to go in.
Oh, that's freaking weird.
Oh no, he's roping it off right now.
No! What's going on? Oh, are you serious? What the frig? What are they roping their freaking pumps off for?
Ask him.
It's probably because it's about to fill it up. This has got to be a joke. Well, I guess I can at least get some food. I'm kind of hungry. I ain't never seen somebody roping off gas pumps before. That's weird. That one lady's like, I ain't freaking leaving. He's about to rope her in. She ain't going. Oh, she's probably gonna like just back out through the caution tape, rip it off. What?
No gas.
No gas.
I said no gas.
Why is that one lady refusing to leave?
I think she's letting her finish.
You think you'd be mad if I like just backed into that last one and just started pumping gas?
Yeah.
Came for one thing, Wawa Hoagie Fest and Double Dutch chocolate milk. Wow, look at that. Gas here.
I have no idea. Somewhere Virginia. There's a sign back there, McCormick Farm. Cyrus McCormick Farm is on this exit. Exit 205. Don't know what the Cyrus McCormick Farm is, and I'm too tired to care. So, caffeine time.
It looks like we're in Raffine.
All is well. No problems. Yep. Now we're back home. Well, close to back home. We got the good stuff. Staying barbecue in Virginia. I have my doubts, but I might be wrong. Almost home, then the low fuel light came on, so I had to get a little more gas before I can make the final stretch, the last 15 minutes of the trip.
back home in North Carolina. Trip up to New York and back, about 1,500 miles. Not really any issues, so a good break-in on a new purchase.